Washington issues Moscow a 60-day ultimatum to comply with a landmark nuclear treaty or warns it will withdraw. Hello, I'm Mike Walter, filling in for Anna Naidu, and this is The Heat. Thirty-one years ago, the United States and the Soviet Union agreed to reduce their nuclear arsenals and ultimately destroyed nearly 2,700 missiles. The Intermediate Range Nuclear Forces Treaty, signed by U.S. President Ronald Reagan and Soviet leader Mikhail Gorbachev in 1987, was viewed as a pivotal moment in ending the Cold War. Now, the United States is threatening to withdraw from that treaty, accusing Russia of violating the pact with a cruise missile program. We begin our coverage with CGTN's Julia Chapman from Moscow. Julia, what's Russia's position in all of this, and how is Russian President Vladimir Putin responding to these allegations by the U.S.?
Well, the Russian government has consistently denied that it has been developing and testing any missiles that breach the INF Treaty. So they have been consistently issuing denials and are saying that they have not been violating this treaty, that the U.S. accuses them of doing so. But President Putin earlier this week was speaking, and he said that if the U.S. does indeed withdraw from the INF Treaty, that Russia will go ahead and start developing such missiles. And today we heard from the Kremlin spokesman Dmitry Peskov, who was saying, reiterating the Russian position that no violations have been made on the Russian side of this agreement, and that Russia is still very much committed to the INF Treaty. So this 60-day ultimatum that the U.S. has issued to Russia to comply with the INF Treaty once again is unlikely to yield any results, because, quite frankly, Russia denies that it has been breaching it in the first place. And also speaking today, we heard from Foreign Minister Sergei Lavrov, who says that he's received absolutely no evidence from the U.S. of these alleged breaches of the INF Treaty, and he says that's consistent with many Western accusations against Russia that never seem to come with any evidence alongside them. So certainly the Russian government is not very happy that the U.S. is withdrawing from this agreement. They say that it's going to make the world a more dangerous place. But Sergei Lavrov was also speaking about the New START treaty, which is due for renewal very soon. That's another arms control treaty between the U.S. and Russia. And Sergei Lavrov says that Russia is very much prepared to go back to the negotiating table on this, but he believes that the U.S. is preparing to tear that agreement up as well.
So we're certainly seeing a war of words. Donald Trump canceling a meeting last week with Vladimir Putin at the G20 summit. But in Helsinki last July, the leaders agreed to address global issues, including arms control. So where do you see the status of U.S.-Russian relations when it comes to these critical talks you were just discussing?
Yes, indeed. So when President Trump announced that he was canceling this meeting with President Putin at the G20 summit last week, the reason that he gave for doing so was the incident in the Kerch Strait that happened a couple of weeks ago, whereby Russian border forces opened fire on and seized three Ukrainian naval vessels there in the Black Sea. So that incident certainly putting the U.S. and Russia even more at odds. And when the meeting was canceled, the Kremlin spokesman said that it meant that important discussions would be indefinitely postponed. And among those, of course, were the INF Treaty, the New START Treaty, as well as the situation in Syria and, of course, the situation in Ukraine. And the Kremlin has also said that any talks of a possible visit of President Putin to Washington, D.C., we had been hearing that that might happen in the next few months, those have been pushed back even further into the distance. So increasingly, we're seeing fewer and fewer opportunities for dialogue between the U.S. and Russia. And with the 60-day ultimatum that the U.S. has now issued Russia, it's unlikely that that's going to improve anytime soon.
Thanks, Julia. That was Julia Chapman reporting from Moscow.